Yo, what's good YouTube? This is Jay from TNJ, and welcome back to the Lions franchise, and we are winding down this series. No secret there, but we pick up off of last episode, in season 9 to start the playoffs. Now, we went 10-4-2 in this past season, and quite frankly, I think that Justin Fields put up his best numbers yet. Because if you look at it, he threw 38 touchdowns, 12 interceptions. He's now 90 overall as we start the playoffs. And he's number 8 ranked quarterback in the NFL. No slouch at all. And I just want to look at his career stats really quick and just look at the progression he's made. 24, 22, and 30 touchdowns. He had a career high 38. 12 interceptions, around his average, I'd say, because last year he had 34-5. That was a great season. But here he almost had 4,000 yards as well, almost his career high in yardage. And then look at that completion percentage, 74% yards per attempt, 8.7. Easily his best season, I would say, for sure. Now, I do want to look at some running backs here because we did not have the season we thought we would have running the ball. Now, Kennedy Brooks, you know, he's always just been a guy. And I think that, you know, I thought that if I propelled him into that starting role, he would kind of excel there, but he has not. Only 600 yards total on the season, so we decided to trade for Trey Everett, and he came through and was actually pretty decent, 77 overall. He has some good speed. I think he has a lot of potential. He's only 24. I think we can do some things building around him in the future. And then on the receiving side of things, you know, I actually signed in free agency KJ Hamler, and he actually led our team in receiving yards and also receptions, and then was second in touchdowns behind Keon Knight, who finished with 11, and a 1,000-yard receiver once again. Superstar X Factor, what can't he do as we go into the playoffs against a team that we're familiar with in Trevor Lawrence and the Minnesota Vikings? Now, the Vikings finished with 6 losses, and looking at Trevor Lawrence, he is 95 overall, the number 2 rated quarterback in the NFL right now. Pat Mahomes is number 1, and looking at the guys they still have, they have some decent guys. Danielle Hunter still there. They actually have a pretty young guy and a third-year player in George Owens. He is a superstar X-factor at 88 overall. He is a number 5 ranked left outside linebacker. He is a monster. I mean, he is a straight monster. And they still do have Stephon Diggs, Irv Smith, Jose Kelly, who was drafted, I believe, in season 2 of this dynasty, but their starting running back, Jamar Jefferson, is going to be out for this game one more week with a broken toe. So that will work in our favor. So let's go over the game day strategy. I obviously will not be playing this game, and I actually don't need to see this at all, to be honest. I just need to simulate this game. Like I said, this is going to be a simulation type series. So let's see who comes out on top. So we escape with the win, our only home field advantage game here in the playoffs in season 9, 331 total yards of offense. Man, what is up with this? I mean, we are just funny. We're just a funny team. It's like we can throw the ball one game, we can't throw the ball next. We can run the ball one game, we can't run the ball next. I mean, we had a good balanced game. 2 touchdowns, no interceptions. Trevor Lawrence threw an interception. Trey Everett had 25 attempts for 80 yards. That might be one of his best games as a pro here for the Lions. And then Cassidy Pace had to step up. He only had 32 yards rushing. Let's see who led the team in receiving. KJ Hamler, 5 for 55. Keon Knight, what is up with him? He has these games where he just doesn't put up the stats. I mean, we have a great receiving core and a tight end here with TJ Hawkinson. We should be airing that thing out. And then on defense, let's just look at them. I can't even go over to sacks. Let's just see. Did anybody have a sack? It looks like James Anderson had a sack for us. And who had the one interception? It was Lonnie Howard, third-year cornerback out of Oregon State. So I'm actually going to switch out the playbook a little bit because I don't think we're utilizing our guys in our scheme a lot. And I want to look at some playbooks like Carolina, for example, that relies on more of a vertical passing scheme. And that's kind of what I want to run because obviously in a sim type of situation, you don't really have control. But I also want to, you know, have a zone running scheme as well. This isn't really a zone running scheme, but I actually like it because it has a lot of shotgun, and I think that Justin Fields benefits a lot from shotgun. And looking at our offensive scheme, air raid, we have a 64% scheme fit, and it's mostly because of our offensive line. So I'm actually going to switch it here to the West Coast spread so more of our guys fit the scheme. The only guys that really don't fit the scheme right now are our running backs, so that's a good sign. So in the divisional round, we go up against the Washington Redskins before heading into this game now. Looks like we do not have any notable player upgrades, only a backup offensive lineman. But let's just look at the Washington Redskins now, because remember, we have had a rivalry with them this entire franchise, and they are still quarterbacked by Dwayne Haskins. Remember, they had Jake Fromm, who they drafted number one overall, I believe, and they did not even play him. I mean, he just sat on the bench and sat behind Dwayne Haskins, who already has a ring here in this franchise. He's only 82 overall. And now Ezekiel Elliott is 32 years old. He is declining now because he was 99 overall for a while. Now he is starting to decline. You can see the progression history. It looks like he's still progressing quite a bit, but his abilities have also went down. And then the receiving core, Jalen Reagor, and then Roman Vines. I'm not sure who Roman Vines is. And then another rookie here, Jabari Newsome, who's actually really, really good. Oh my goodness, 79 overall as a rookie, star development. It looks like they're pretty much set up for the future again. And just like that, the season comes to an end, as maybe that offensive change with the scheme hurt us. I don't know, because we did not put up any yards of offense, only 228 total yards. Wow. Justin Fields went only one touchdown, one interception, 159 yards. Ezekiel Elliott, we actually held him in check. Trey Everett did not run the ball well, though, only 31 yards receiving or rushing. But then on the offensive side, I mean, nobody really showed up. KJ Hamler got into the end zone. Keon Knight almost finished with 100 yards, and we just did not get it done. This kind of sucks. Ends our season here in the divisional round for back-to-back years now, and it seems like that's been our fate the last few years as we go into the offseason. Let's just find out who wins the Super Bowl. Right now in the divisional round, it looks like the Dolphins are moving on to the AFC Championship. And like I said, the Browns are always there. I don't know what's up with this. And then the Saints Redskins, they've been there a lot in this franchise. So let's just take a look at awards here in Season 9. Lamar Jackson actually wins his third MVP here in this franchise. Pretty high expectation he has in Baltimore, and he has lived up to them. And just looking at the rest of the guys here, let's see if any of our guys win. Justin Fields finishes second in best quarterback, so that's actually pretty good for us. And let's see if anybody finished close in best receiver. Keon Knight and Hamler were 6 and 7 respectively, but we get the best offensive lineman. That's what we've been predicated off of this entire franchise. D'Angelo Boone, who we drafted, I believe, after season 3 in the first round, he was pretty good. Alonzo Aldridge, a pretty young safety of ours, actually ends up third in best DB. That's pretty good. So it looks like the Browns do end up with Super Bowl 62 now as we move into season 10. We have some questions to answer, and quite frankly, the biggest one is really getting Justin Fields locked up. And I think he's the last huge piece. And I do want to lock up Bryant Ryan. He has been a loyal guy. Trey Everett, Ali Gray, all these main guys, I'm probably going to lock them up and get them re-signed. But the main question here is Justin Fields. Now, I think we should give him this big contract. I think he has earned it, and we are pretty much going to be out of cap room after this contract. But he showed me, I put him on a franchise tag last year, and he's shown now that he is worthy of a big contract. So we're going to give him a 5-year, $163 million deal. Hopefully he accepts it, because I do not want to put him on the tag again. And he does not. And he will have to go on the tag. A 1-year, $35 million tag. So now our cap room is getting a little low. So that means that we're going to have to either go after one of these, two of these four guys. And I think the two most important are Ali Gray and I would say Bryant Ryan. So we're going to sign Ali Gray to a 5-year. I'm not going to give him $65 million. I'm probably going to, well, let's see what it resets to. So a fair offer is 4 years, $37 million. And it says we're auto-correcting right now to 5 years, $46 million. I think that's actually pretty good. I'm going to give him 5 years, $52 million. And hopefully he accepts that. We'll have him until age 32. And he's going to test free agency. Wow. So he turns that down. That means that we have a lot of money. And we're going to give it to Brian Ryan because I cannot risk having another guy on the market. Why did Ali Gray reject that? Wow, he does not want to stay in Detroit. And I'm going to give Brian Ryan a big contract, the contract that maybe Trey Flowers was asking for back after season 3, I believe that was. And we're going to give him the 4-year, $70 million deal, locking him up so he will accept that. And now we have enough money to probably lock up our right tackle now, Jack Spell. Ali Gray walks. Wow, that's really, really surprising. Let's sign Jack Spell to age 30 now. I can't believe he's that old. He's 27 now. And, oh, we don't have enough cap room. Oh, my goodness. We're going to have to let him go. I mean, we don't have enough cap room. We're going to have to go to the draft now. So Justin Fields, that franchise tag really did handicap us because now we're going to have to let some of our top guys walk. Ali Gray is going to have to walk. Let's just look at the top guys. Jalen Ramsey is now a free agent at age 33, and we're definitely going to need to address that safety position. Good thing we did get Carlos Wright, and we also have some other young cornerbacks and safeties on our roster because we just didn't have enough for Ali Gray. And look at Jack Spell. Nobody's really offering him a deal yet. So let's get back in that. Let's just sign him to a contract. We do not have any type of cap at all. I'm going to have to lowball him because we have no cap. So I'm going to just give him a 2-year, $4.2 million. I mean, I think that's a pretty good deal, to be honest. Only 42 points. I mean, this is sad. Let's just see if we end up getting him. That's all we can really afford. So believe it or not, we are not going to sign anybody in free agency. I don't think I've ever done this before, but we just do not have the cap room. And I just want to look at every position. Quarterback and running back, we kind of have solidified a little bit. I do want to get another running back because now we just traded for running back. We have to let him go since we don't have enough money. But then looking at receiver, we're pretty much set there. I'm not really worried about receiver this year. Really, the offensive line is the issue now because we drafted Morris Thomas last offseason. Quinn Bryant, Ragnow, D'Angelo Boone, and all of our other guys are locked up. But right tackle is now a position of need. We have nobody at right tackle that is really good enough to start there. But every other position is pretty much locked up. And that's, a good thing. Now that we let Ali Gray go, we now have to rely on the third-year guy, Alonzo Allridge. And he actually is going to be pretty good. Out of Indiana State, 73 overall, not too bad. Carlos Wright is a superstar trait, so we have another young safety to build around. And that's just how rosters are built. Sometimes you have to let your superstars go. You can't afford to pay them. So I'd say after the draft, we do have an opportunity to go get some free agent running backs. Trey Sermon went unsigned. A.J. Dillon did as well. They are 27 and 28 respectively. But let's just look at where Jack Spell did end up. And hopefully he did not end up in our division. He did not. With the Eagles, a 2-year, $13.2 million total. And really, we had no chance. So we are here in the first round, and really, you know, I have my eyes on a tackle here, Landon Logan. Now, he is a late first round talent, and let me just pause this clock really quick. I don't want that clock to be on, but, you know, one guy that really sticks out to me is that tackle, but there's a guy at the top of the board here that has fell into our lap at pick 25, Bob Foster. What a name that is, but look at his combine. How did he not get drafted? He is 22 years old, an early first round talent. Look at these top skills. A minus. I mean, one of the fastest guys. I mean, this guy is a home run of a pick here. And I just want to look around him to see if there's any other first round talent. And there is. Look at this. Another middle linebacker, Walter Reynolds. I mean, he's another guy. If he falls to us in the second round, we have an opportunity to be great. Another first-round talent here. Evan Filipic? I don't know how to say that name. But look at this. Another early first-round talent. I mean, these guys are falling. but I would be damned if I do not get Bob Foster here at the end of the first round, an early first round. Finally, a running back to build around. 78 overall. He is ranked number one in true talent, and we drafted him at number 25. So we got the best guy in the draft here. He is not hitting dev traits, so he is just normal development. But man, is this guy good. We lucked up and got a good one here in Bob Foster. So here in the second round, I am just going to address the tackle position. Looking at the guys around us, Landon Logan is a fourth round projection, but a first round talent. Just looking at the other offensive linemen, nobody really has the talent that Logan has. This is a no-brainer pick here since we have him scouted. And let's just do it. 70 overall, hidden dev traits. So he's going to be either a star, superstar, or superstar X-factor. We'll have to see. Number 26 in true talent. We drafted him at 56. That is actually really good value. We're doing well so far. So looking at salaries, and before I make my next pick, you know, there's some positions I do need to address because a lot of guys are going to be free agents, and I don't know if I will have the cap space for them. And looking at Vincent McLeod, he is 29 years old at cornerback. Dean is still locked up for a couple of years, but James Anderson will be a free agent as well. And then Justin Fields, obviously, we need to keep the cap for him. But we need to do some things with these positions that I just specified. And running back, at least we addressed that there in the first round. And then we also need some more linebacker depth because we don't have a long-term solution there. So I go to cornerback here and look at some cornerback depth since we might be losing Vincent McLeod next season. I'm looking at Courtney Witherspoon. He is a first-round talent, fifth-round projection. Might as well go after the guy with the most talent here. And he ends up being 69 overall. He's number 32 in true talent. We picked him at 89. And let's just look at him. He's 93 speed, 89 excel. Isn't really a cover guy at all. He's got a while to develop. Also, Frank Ragnow on the offensive line is going to be a free agent next season. So why not get another good talent here on the offensive line? Marcus Colombo, 21 years old, mid-second round talent. And we did get good value out of him. And we can possibly move him over to center, get him some reps there. We'll see how he develops. He's pretty good right now. Good run blocking. Now we're here in the fifth round, and the talent level has definitely took a dip. And just looking at everybody I scouted, I even scouted some third round projected guys, and they ended up not even being worthy of being drafted. So I'm pretty sure I'm going to try to trade some picks or something. I don't know. Maybe get a couple of these guys. Why not just go after the top guy, see what he is? Eli Campbell, he doesn't look very good, to be honest. Nothing really sticking out. Let's just take a chance and get him. 55 overall, nothing special. He's not even good. So we end up with pretty decent talent here with our first four picks with Colombo, Witherspoon, Logan, and Foster. And let's just see how we compare to the rest of the NFL. And let's just look round by round to see where we kind of ranked as far as overall goes. And Jason Harrison was the top pick. He ends up being 72 overall. Wow, there's a 64 overall drafted in the first round ahead of Bob Foster, who was the best at pick number 25. That's actually really, really good. And I can't wait to develop him. That's going to be fun. Looking at the second round, look at this. We had the third best pick. So we actually had a couple of good first rounds here as Filipich, or whatever, however you say that name, at quarterback. He ends up being 77 overall. Let's just look at him really quickly. He ends up being hidden dev trait. Man, he would have been awesome to get in the first round as well, since we might have to lose Justin Fields. And let's just look at him. Man, is he good. 95 throw power, 86 medium. He looks like he's going to be special. In the third round, where did we end up? We ended up with the fourth best. So we actually did pretty good so far. So through three rounds, we have, you know, some top players. And then in the fourth, the second best. I mean, we did an awesome job in this draft with those first four picks. I'm actually really, really encouraged by these picks. So I think this is a good stopping point as we wanted to get through the offseason here in season 9. And let's just look at the depth chart now. And I believe next episode will be the final one. Get through 10 seasons, I think that is good. And we have had quite the journey. At quarterback, Justin Fields will be our starter for the final season. Bob Foster, I'm going to start at running back. I think I like him better than Kennedy Brooks right now, especially since he's a rookie. I want to see what he's going to do. Keon Knight, KJ Hamler, and you know what? Dustin Revolt, man, can you say enough about this guy? Undrafted free agent after season one. Started out at 57 overall. He is at 78. He has progressed a lot better than Marlon Yarbrough. Can you believe that? He will be our slot guy this year. TJ Hockenson, still 91 overall, sticking with the squad. Morris Thomas, who we drafted in the first round last season. Quinn Bryant, Frank Ragnow, also D'Angelo Boone, who was the offensive best lineman of the year in the NFC. And then Landon Logan, the rookie, will start at right tackle. Ryan Ryan starts at left. Will Knowles, who, remember, I actually was very, very high on him last season, but he got hurt. He will be the starter at right end. And then our defensive tackles are kind of weak. Michael Hunt, we drafted last year as well, along with Will Knowles. Those two will be the second-year guys on the defensive line. James Anderson enters the last year of his contract at left outside linebacker. Jelani Tavai has kind of regressed. We will take a closer look at him at the end of this episode. Trey Dean is going to be the number one cornerback, along with Vincent McLeod playing on his last year. And then Witherspoon will be the third cornerback there. We do take a drop off at free safety, losing Ali Gray. And then Carlos Wright, going into his third season, will be the starter at strong safety. Now, I want to take a closer look at Jelani Tavai, now age 31, and he has been a bell cow of the defense. Is that even a thing? I mean, this guy has been amazing for me. 10 seasons, and I got to say, he has been fun to play with. Really, really fun. He's 75 overall. He has regressed a little bit, it looks like. Yep. I mean, he's getting older, getting up there in age now. And in real life, only going into his second year. So it's been fun playing with him. And then let's take a look at Rich Patton. He is still 28 years old, 91 overall. He should be the number one. Yep, he is. Number one right outside linebacker in the game right now. And he has been a treat to play with as well. And then let's just take a look at Keon Knight entering season 10 in his fifth season now. Superstar X Factor, number five ranked wide receiver. He is an amazing guy to have on your squad. And then how could we forget about Justin Fields? Two Super Bowls in a total of nine seasons now for the Lions. Let's go for one more in season 10. This is gonna be a ton of fun. And looking at Justin Fields, this is bittersweet. I gotta admit, this is bittersweet. He is a number eight ranked quarterback in the league right now. And let's just look at our schedule here in the final season of this franchise. And we looks like we will play a couple of divisional opponents to start it out. Looks like we play the Colts. So does that mean we're playing the AFC South? It does, because we play the Texans, Titans, and Jaguars. So, and then we play the NFC East, like always. Why do we always play the NFC East? That's really stupid. I want to play some other divisions. And then it looks like we play a little bit of the NFC West. I don't think we play every single opponent in the West. Just looks like the Seahawks here. So looks like we're gonna play, it looks like, the NFC West and the AFC South. NFC East and the AFC South. Those are gonna be the two big divisions we play this season. So one last ride, ladies and gentlemen, before we end this franchise here with the Lions. It's been a ton of fun. Morris Thomas here before the start of the season has an upgrade. He goes up to 78 overall in his second season with the team. And looking at him, he is 24 ranked left tackle. We're just going to manually upgrade. No, we're actually going to upgrade Landon Logan, who is our starter at right tackle. And he is a hidden dev trait. Let's upgrade that power blocking there. Oh, upgraded the pass protector on accident. But he still goes up to overall 71. He goes up plus four in awareness, so that's pretty good. And he is a number 46 ranked left tackle. And because he's at right tackle, it really doesn't rank him there. But that's going to do it here in this episode as we kick off season 10 in next episode. I can't wait. And it's been bittersweet, but it's about time here in this series to come to an end in one more episode, one last ride, one last season. Hit subscribe, hit that like button, stay tuned. Let's get it. Let's go. Yeah.
Hey, filling out these job applications. Life got hard after high school graduation. I went to college and your boy got financial aid. They gave me money, then I went and bought a pair of J's. And I bought a pair of shades. And I bought a new computer. Half $100 left, spent the rest on...